Welcome back to Fun on the Run. There are so many amazing museums right here in the Metroplex, but there's only one with a collection of unusual and quirky pieces that will have you questioning the truth. Stephanie Mendez is taking us to Ripley's Believe It or Not.
This palace behind me is iconic, and inside lies so many attractions, wax figures, and history that is sure to blow your mind. Let's head inside Grand Prairie's Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Ripley's Believe It or Not here in Grand Prairie has five attractions under one roof. So we have the Ripley's Believe It or Not Auditorium, the Louis Tussauds Palace of Wax, an Enchanted Mirror Maze, 70 Moving Theater, and then a laser game. So it's fun for the whole family.
Lino, this is probably one of the most iconic features of Ripley's. I mean, besides like all the other crazy things, this is the one that like you grow up and you like see celebrities getting a wax figure, or like it's just a really big deal. So tell me about this feature of Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Yes, so right now we're currently in our Hollywood section, so you're gonna find all your Hollywood stars. Yes, all of these wax figures are unique to them, and the height proportions, their facial structure, it's all uniquely ours, but it's also theirs as well.
So this is the Hollywood section, and then tell me about the other little sections that people can experience when they're coming through the wax figures.
Sure, we have at least like 10 different galleries. So we have our President's Gallery, we have a talk show, we have a Western, we have superheroes, we have a biblical section, historical. So any little interest or niche that you might have, we got you covered.
That's really fun, because I feel like this is something that kids will see and think like, oh, they're seeing their favorite celebrity. But at the same time, like, they're also getting a little bit of a history lesson when they're walking by and they're like, I don't know who that is. And their parents can kind of explain to them who it is, right?
Yeah, exactly. There is so many kids that walk in here and they're like, I don't know who that is. But at the same time, they'll know the Avengers, they'll know the Minions, they'll know, everyone will know at least somebody here.
What's your favorite section so far?
Ooh, my favorite section, I think, is our fear section at the very end. It has all your classic, like, horror monsters, so Freddy Krueger, you have Texas Chainsaw, and yeah, it's gotten a lot scarier during the years, so yeah.
I've seen the scary stuff, I've seen the really cool stuff, but we're here at the actual Ripley's Auditorium. Tell me all about what people can expect here.
Yeah, so right here, we're right outside the Ripley's Auditorium. All the weird and wacky that you can imagine is gonna be right behind me. So anything from genuine shrunken heads to the world's tallest man, weird taxidermy, even ancient weapons are gonna be right back here. We have older stuff, we have more contemporary weird pieces of art that you would not expect someone to make a giant portrait of Katy Perry with lipstick.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, everything is familiar but wacky, but you don't know what's gonna happen. You
and
know?
That's really the overall goal of Ripley's, is like just weird, funky things.
Yes.
We were talking a little bit earlier. Tell me how you guys like find these pieces and how they even make it in here.
Yes. So some of these were collected actually by Robert Ripley, who Ripley's Believe It or Not is based off of. So in his journeys, he's gathered some of these. A lot of these people reach out to us and say, hey, we have a giant ball of yarn that we have. And a lot of that is collected that way.
How can people kind of purchase tickets or decide what they want to do and how they want to do it?
Sure. So you're able to buy tickets either through our website or Facebook or in person. I always recommend in person just so we kind of give you a lay of the land and recommend what we see best fit for yourself and your family. But the more you do, the more you save. So I always recommend doing all five, which is our super combo. There are some more interesting stuff for the adults, but then it's also super interactive for the kiddos. We have a giant dancing room. We have a brand new gallery, which is super hands-on and interactive for the kids, and as well as just familiar stuff that they'll get to know and they've seen before.
Yay.
But wacky.
Wacky, and we love it. We're all full of wacky here. Of course, you guys got the lowdown of how you guys can get tickets, but if I were you, I would definitely come and see every attraction. Maybe take a day or 2 days, bring your loved ones out here. It's really the perfect place for some interesting things that Dallas has to offer. Of course, I'll have all that information and more on our website at cw33.com.